Hey church, happy new year to you. I don't know how you're feeling about the year that's ahead of us, 2021. You know, what's it gonna bring? What's it gonna look like for every single one of us? I wanna just say to you right at the outset of this year, I believe with all my heart, God is with you. I know many of you know that already, but I want to just remind you, God is with you. In fact, He's more than with you. He's gone ahead of you already into 2021. And here's the thing, you know, God is in control. Despite everything that's going on around us, despite the lack of control that we might feel right now, the disappointment of everything that seems to still be happening around us, God is in control. When life feels uncertain, we need to remind ourselves that God is certain. And I really want to encourage you with that, that I believe that God wants to lead you into fruitfulness this year. I pray that it'll be a year of blessing over you and your family, despite what's happening in the natural all around us. I want to just share a few things with you by way of a pastor's update, really, because some significant things have happened over the last 48 hours. We find ourselves in lockdown 3.0. Who would have thought when we entered lockdown 1 that we would have had a lockdown 3? Not me. I didn't realize, I didn't know at the time that this was going to happen. But here we are, beginning of a new year and the beginning of another lockdown. As a staff and leadership team, we've taken the last 24 hours to talk, to think, to pray about what our response is to the latest lockdown. Because while the measures and the restrictions in place actually allow for churches to gather for the purpose of worship services, we have to ask the question, just because we can, should we? Just because we are able and can gather, should we gather? Is that the best thing for us to do? Is that the way that we demonstrate love and care for one another? We have always strived in our regathering process for this place to be a safe place for people to gather. We want it to be a space that is free from COVID, and we've done all that we can, everything we can, gone above and beyond to try and make this a safe space, whether it is for you attending on a Sunday or for any one of our teams that serve here on a Sunday morning. And so as we recognize that in the local area in which we live, as we recognize that rates have gone up. In fact, in Letchworth alone, we've seen rates quadruple over the last few weeks. We've heard more stories of people within our church, the part of our family and our community, who have tested positive for COVID-19, or members of their household have tested positive for COVID-19. We are hearing more and more and more of these stories. And so, after much time of prayer and conversation over the last 24 hours, we have taken the decision, out of a place of care for everyone who comes here on a Sunday, to, for the foreseeable future, to stop in-person services. I'll be honest, it was not an easy decision. I love our times of gathering together, not just in person, but those online. I love all of it. I love seeing people on a Sunday. I have found this a really hard decision, but I believe it's the right decision. And so for the foreseeable future, we are going to stop in-person services here on a Sunday. However, as you know, and as we have been all the way through, we will remain online every Sunday, 11:15 a.m., bringing the LGCC family together for worship and encouragement with one another. This really is a season, church, for us to step up in prayer, to be praying for one another, to be the church in our care, in our demonstration to one another of the love of Jesus Christ and how we look out for one another. But I really believe it's a time for us to stir one another in prayer. It's no coincidence that next week, starting on the 11th of January, right through to the 15th of January, we're going to be having 5 days of prayer, a week of prayer where we gather together 3 times a day to pray, to seek the heart of God, to hear from heaven and begin to pray that His kingdom would come and transform our streets and neighborhoods, our communities that we live in, the cities, the towns that surround us, and indeed the United Kingdom. We want to encourage you, gather with us next week, 7:15 a.m., 12 noon, and 8 p.m. every day. gather with us. Perhaps you're not somebody who ordinarily would gather with us during a week of prayer or in our regular rhythm of prayer. We really want to ask you and encourage you, join with us next week. We believe that there is power when the whole church comes together in unity with one another to seek the face of God. We want to do just that. Come and join with us. You can find out more information on our website. It's all on there. Details of how to log into prayer, where it's available. You can find all the information there available for you and others who may want to join us. But we want to just pray God's blessing on you. We love you. We are praying for you. We are cheering you on. If there is a way that we can serve you or help you in this season, please do pick up the phone, talk to us, email us, get in touch with us. We would love to hear from you. But stay safe. Pray you know God's blessing over your life and over your home and those around you. God bless you.